Turn on kitchen lights.
Turned on light.
Do you know that little guy called Atomeho that costs around 13 bucks? Well, we are turning it into the most private voice assistant for your smart home and your home assistant. Picture this, you sit on your couch, you press a button on this little guy, you throw out some voice commands, the commands gets executed and you get responses from this small device. All of this entirely locally, no cloud, no subscriptions, no fee, no governments listening to your conversation, no nothing. It's like living in your own protected smart bubble. But before we dive into this awesome tutorial, I've got a quick shout out. This video is made possible by me, Kirill, and Home Assistant crew who made this project so easy and fun. By the way, if you are new to this channel, consider subscribing. Alright, let's get into the details of this Atomeho and voice assistant transformation. So, we are on a mission to make the Atomeho the voice boss of your smart home. Here is what you're gonna need to make this magic happen. First thing is the latest and greatest home assistant. If you need more info about that part and different installation types, go check my home assistant webinar. It is all free. Next thing needed is the password of your 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi network, because this baby needs to talk. A Chrome or Edge browser is also needed. And of course, the star of the show, the M5 Stack Atomeho Development Kit. I'll leave an affiliate link to that device in Amazon. But be aware that there is a small issue here. These devices are not always in stock, so you better check their availability every now and then. Final thing that is needed is Home Assistant Assist local or cloud pipeline. Don't worry, I'll cover this in a second. And I know that I said this will be local only, and it can be, as you'll see later, but if you wish to use cloud services, that is also possible. And as always, there are some pros and cons. If you use a cloud pipeline, you need an internet connection, Nabucasa subscription, and your data will be processed by third parties, which theoretically may turn evil at some point. But you have more voices and languages at your disposal, as well as everything will be fast, and the model language will understand your comments better. If you stay local only, your data will never leave your home network. It will be all free, but there may be a delay of the voice commands processing part depending on the system on which you run Home Assistant and the chosen transcription model. But let's see this in action instead of just talking. I'll press the C button and I'll head on to Home Assistant add-on store and I'll search for Piper add-on and I'll install it. Before I start the add-on, I can go to the configuration type and here I can change the voice, but I'll leave the default one. I'll go back and I'll start the add-on. Of course, you can enable the watchdog and auto-update options if you wish. After that, I'll go to add-on store again and this time I'll search for Whisper, which is the speech-to-text add-on that I need to install as well. I'll click install. I'll go again to the configuration tab and here I can change the transcription model. This is the default one. This is the smallest one that is suitable for Raspberry Pi 4, although it will still work with some delays. This is the most advanced and bigger ones. And if you have a very strong machine on which you're running your Home Assistant, you can select that one. Of course, you can try all of these models. They are different size. The smaller models are less accurate, but much faster. I'll select this one, the default one. I'll go back to the Info tab and I'll click Start. Again, you can enable Watchdog and Auto-Update options, but that's kind of optional. The Whisper add-on is now started and I'll go to the integration section of Home Assistant. I pressed the C button to invoke this command window and I'll type integrations and I'll select navigate integrations. And here in the integration section, I can find how to discover Piper and Whisper add-ons. I'll just have to click configure, submit. And the same thing on the Whisper add-on. Now I can use these in Home Assistant Assist. I'll go to the overview section of Home Assistant. I'll click on this Assist button. Then I'll click on this arrow and I'll select Manage Assistants. This is where I can configure pipelines. If I wish to use the cloud pipeline, I just have to enable this Nabucasa subscription, which have a monthly fee, and you can try it for 1 month for free. Enabling this will also add a cloud assist pipeline that you can use by selecting it from here. If you want to go local only, you can add assistant. You can name it whatever you wish. Local pipeline, for example. You can change the language from here to any of the supported ones. For example, Bulgarian, but I'll switch back to English. As a speech-to-text engine, you can choose Whisper, the add-on that we just installed. Again, you can select the English here. And for the text-to-speech engine, I can choose Piper. That's the add-on that we just installed. From this drop-down, you can select different voice. In the brackets, it is stated the quality of these voices. Low, medium, and high. You can click on Try Voice. It takes some time.
Hello, how can I assist?
It takes a lot of time, but it works. And I can click Create. Now I have a local pipeline, but it is not the default one. To make it a default one, I have to click on it again and to select the start button, then to click update. And now I'm ready with my local pipeline and I can continue with uploading software on my Atom Echo device. Before this tiny titan called Atom Echo can play nice with Home Assistant, we need to get a bit of software on it. Now here is where things get interesting. I'll start the Chrome browser because this macOS Safari browser is not supported. And I'll open the following URL. I'll scroll down a bit and I'll click on this connect button. This is my devices connected to the serial port. And right now I'll connect my Atom Echo using USB-C cable to my computer. Like that. I'll click on allow. Try again and I can see my M5 stack USB serial port. If this is not visible, I'll cancel this. And from here I can install this driver for Windows or Mac depending of the operating system that I'm using. And I can try again, but I'll cancel that. I'll click connect. I'll select my M5 stack Atom Echo and I'll click connect. I'll select install voice assistant, install again. Keep this page visible to prevent slowdowns. This is a good tip. Try to listen to it. It will take 2 minutes. I think it's much faster, but we'll see. Wrapping up. Installation complete. I can click next now and I have to configure my Wi-Fi. From this drop down I can choose my other Wi-Fis. I can click connect. And my Atom Echo device is now connected to my Wi-Fi network and I can add it to my Home Assistant. This is my Home Assistant IP that I previously configured, but now I need to change that. The IP is different because I have several Home Assistant environments and this time I'm using this one. I'll update it. In your case, you just have to type the IP of your Home Assistant and the default port 8123 and I'll hit open a link. Now I have to authenticate. I want to set up ESP Home. I'll click OK. And I'll select my M5 stack Atom Echo device, submit, and finish. This is it. I can now find the device under my ESP Home integration. And it seems that it is working. Now, the fun part. Giving orders to your home assistant using your Atom Echo. Here is where it gets cool. Throw out some voice commands like a pro. Give that rounded shape button a tap. Turn on kitchen lights.
Turned on light.
Simple, right? Ask questions like how many lights are on in the kitchen? Are there any lights on in the kitchen?
Yes, kitchen lights.
Wonder if the door is locked? Ask away. And if you feel like a tech wizard, add custom comments using sentence triggers. Sometimes a little tune-up is needed if your Atom Echo takes a sweet time. Tweak the silence detection settings. Head to Settings, Device and Services, ESP Home Integration, find your Atom Echo and try all of the options one by one to find the one that best suits you. And just like that, the Atom Echo is transformed into the ultimate voice assistant for your smart home. Go on, issue those voice commands, task in the future, and remember, you're living it, my friend. Before we wrap up this smart home journey, I have a special treat for you. If you are eager to dive deeper into the world of smart homes and gain comprehensive understanding of key terms, I've prepared a smart home glossary as PDF file. It's yours to download for free from my website, automatelike.pro/glossary. Go get it and keep the tech magic alive. I'm Kirill. Until next time,